A new study has found alarming amounts of toxic chemicals in breast milk that could cause severe problems for an entire generation. Wow. I mean, you know, it just never ends. And the fact is, this story has been out there a long time. Corporate media is just now picking up on it. Matter of fact, we did this story earlier before corporate media even knew what was taking place. Talk about it a little bit.
Yeah, this major study by three different universities, a research institute, took samples of breast milk, and what they found was it wasn't 75% had traces of these chemicals. It wasn't 90. It was 100% of the breast milk samples that they tested had these levels of PFAS chemicals that could be damaging to the infant. So we're talking about an entire generation being poisoned right now.
You helped do the research on the case that I tried, the PFAS case that I tried up in the Ohio River Valley. They made two movies about it. One was The Devil We Know. The other one is Dark Waters. And in that trial, what we found was that this information has been on the table for the EPA for decades, literally for decades.
Yeah.
We're talking about four decades at the very least. And this is what they knew. They knew it caused cancer. All the animal studies show it showed cancer. It caused liver disease. It caused liver cancer. Caused testicular disease. Caused developmental disease. This is what the EPA had, and the local regulators actually became part of furthering the efforts to get more PFAS into the Ohio River Valley. It's a remarkable story, and it's just beginning, isn't it?
It really is, and we're finding out again, this poisoning goes so far beyond. I mean, we're finding these chemicals in areas where human beings don't even live.
Mm-hmm.
We're finding it in polar bears, mm-hmm. for God's sake. That is how widespread these chemicals are. And again, we've already poisoned a couple of generations. And because of inaction from the federal government, because the companies continue to produce these chemicals still going out into the waters today, we got a new generation right here getting toxic doses of these.
You know, matter of fact, you did a story on this for National Trial Lawyer Magazine. In that story, you talk about the fact, and I tried the case, so I had the experts on the stand that said it's biopersistent, means it's in the environment for 1 million years. It's bioaccumulative. That means each and every time that you take a drink of it or you're exposed to it, it adds to the burden in your body. And more importantly, it's bioactive. And when you put all those three things together, and now you learn that the most important stage in a child's life, they're exposed to 10, 20, 50 times the amount. They should have no exposure.
Right.
God didn't make PFAS, okay? DuPont and 3M made PFAS.
Right. And there may be not a whole lot we can do at this point to stop the poisoning of this generation other than what we're doing right now, what you've done, trying these cases, getting the word out. But again, these are chemicals that are still being introduced today,
mm-hmm.
right? They're still in use. And some of the alternatives are proving to be almost equally as toxic. So we're at the mercy of corporate America right now. We truly are, and it's a terrifying place to be.
Netflix, check out Netflix, The Devil We Know. It's going to give you the whole backstory. It's scary, scary stuff. Farron Cousins, thank you for joining me, okay?
Thank you.